Assalamu alaikum everyone, this is Ms. Kamal Sumer and today we are going to start another reader of Cambridge Reading Adventures. By the end of this lesson, learners will be able to read and comprehend the text and understand the meaning of difficult words. Let's see today's plan. First of all, there is going to be introduction of the reader, after it, live reading of chapter 1, and then homework and digital resources will be shared. This is a cover page with the title The Refugee Camp, which is written by Jim Aldrich. The beautiful and colorful illustrations are done by Tom Sperling. This is a title page which with title, author and illustrator name again along with publisher name, which is Cambridge University Press. This is a back cover where you can read the blurb from. Let's see what it says. When the war comes, Ahmed and his family leave the city in search for a better future. But life in the tent camp proves to be very difficult. Sounds interesting. Let's see what happens with Ahmed. During loud reading, you will be able to see the meaning of difficult words on your right-hand side. See them for better understanding. Subscribe my channel and press the bell icon for more relevant and comprehensive videos.
Ahmed!
11-year-old Ahmed got in field, heading for the tent city goal. The supporters of J-Stars chanted and shouted in excitement. J-Stars were one of the best teams in the refugee camps under-15 football league. The rest of the tent city team ran back as fast as they could to protect their goal. The Tent City central defender, Bozen, a tall, powerfully built boy of almost 15, was the only one between Ahmed and the goalkeeper. A roar went up from J-Star supporters as Ahmed flicked the ball past Bozen.
"Shoot!" yelled the crowd excitedly.
Crunch! Woos and shouts of disapproval were heard as Bozen made a crunching tackle from behind that caught Ahmed's ankle and sent him crashing to the hard, dusty sand. Ahmed rolled over, his face wreathed in pain. The referee blew his whistle and wagged a warning finger at Bozen. Ahmed's best pal, Mustafa, helped Ahmed to his feet.
"That hurt,"
winced Ahmed. He looked at his ankle, which was bruised and bleeding from the studs of Bozen's boot.
"The referee should have sent Bozen off," complained Mustafa.
"That was a goal-scoring opportunity. We would have scored, we would have drawn. And with Tent City, the top team in the league."
"Maybe, or they will score from the free kick," said Ahmed.
"No chance," said Mustafa. "Tent City have had time to get their defense back in the place."
Mustafa was right. Ordil's shot was blocked by the wall of defenders. As the ball was kicked into touch, the final whistle went. With Tent City the winners, 3-2. As Ahmed limped off the pitch, he found Bozen blocking his path. And not just Bozen, Bozen's gang was with him. And it included some older boys.
"How is your ankle?"
sneered Bozen nastily. Ahmed didn't answer. Bozen and his gang had a bad reputation as bullies in the camp. Bozen put his face close to Ahmed's.
"You made me look a fool today,"
he said angrily.
"You made me look slow."
"I was just playing football," protested Ahmed.
"If you ever do that to me again, what I do to your ankle will be just the start,"
Bozen said threateningly. Then he stamped on Ahmed's injured foot and pushed him so hard that Ahmed fell to the ground.
"Remember what I said?"
sneered Bozen. Mustafa had seen what happened and came over to Ahmed after Bozen and his gang had gone.
"Are you all right?" asked Mustafa.
"Yes," said Ahmed, getting to his feet. "He's just a bully."
"He is a bully with a gang, and he's bigger and tougher than you," said Mustafa. "He's really angry that you scored twice against his team today. No one has done that to him before. That's why 10 City are the top of the league. If you take my advice, you will keep away from him.
At least we won't be playing 10 City again for a while, said Ahmed.
It's time to see the homework. Read chapter 1 of Refugee Camp and prepare for spelling and dictation MA of 10 marks on this Friday. Best of luck!
In Digital Resource, there is a live worksheet to review the concept of comparative and superlative adjectives. Give it a try and enjoy.
That's enough for today. See you in next lesson. Till then, take care. Allah Hafiz.
Don't forget to subscribe my channel and press the bell icon. Comment down and let me know which lessons you want me to cover in my upcoming videos. Take care.